For those of us that have been around to see all of those, it was sweet revenge in the Georgia Dome, because I saw every one of those and it was very difficult to take each and every time, whether it was Big Ben, whether it was Grover Clemmer and the Phantom Flag, or Morton Anderson sticking a dagger in his former team by kicking a game-winning field goal. Now here's the common denominator among all three of those games. Ricky Jackson did not play in any of those. Two were in the 70s, one was in the late 90s. So Ricky gets a hall pass on this one. Ken Trahan, Sports NOAA TV, the New Orleans Saints closed out their 2015 season with their second consecutive win, defeating the Falcons 20-17. Another stellar performance by Drew Brees. He was flawless. Numbers should have even been better. Drops in the game. But here's the key on Drew. Four straight games without a turnover. Terrific. The Saints won the turnover battle. They win the game. And it's their sixth season sweep of the Falcons since 2006. And simply put, Sean Payton owns the Atlanta Falcons. 15-5 against them as head coach of the New Orleans Saints. So, Brian, every time you see a close game between these two, which is more often than not, you just expect the Saints will find a way to win it, or the Falcons will find a way to lose it, or both. And that's kind of what happened yesterday.
I agree. I just sensed as the game neared an end there that Matty Ice Ryan was going to melt under the pressure. And sure enough, as we talked about off air, Kenny, if Sanford doesn't make that INT, there was another defender right there to make it. So just there's a reason why Atlanta blew a 5-0 start, seventh team in NFL history not to make the playoffs after a 5-0 start.
Well, the Saints have had a better coach. Sean Payton's a better coach than Mike Smith, and he's a better coach than Dan Quinn right now, Ricky. But the other part of that is the Saints have had Drew Brees and the Falcons have had Matt Ryan. Matt Ryan's got talent, but he's not Drew Brees, and that's another reason why the Saints have beaten the Falcons with regularity.
Yeah, we got the top three quarterbacks in the lead. I mean, I put Drew right up there with the top, quarterbacks. Ain't nobody better than Drew, and especially the way he threw the ball yesterday. I mean, when you get him inside, he can really, throw the ball. But, Atlanta coaches, man, I don't know what they was thinking about yesterday. I mean, you got 1:40 left, and you go throw an interception on the first ball when you should have ran both balls, made the Saints use both of their timeout. And now on third down, you don't get it, you punt the ball, at least you go into overtime. So, that was just bad coaching yesterday.
Well, they put the game in Matt Ryan's hands, and those are not the most dependable hands to put them in. Truth be told, Jamarcus Sanford made a great play, but if he doesn't, there's another white shirt right there. Yeah. It's just not a good decision. Brian, a couple of guys that played well were Travaris Cadet and Brandon Coleman. That said, they kind of undid their performances. Cadet by fumbling at the goal line, and Coleman by dropping a pass that would have at least gone for 40 yards, maybe for a touchdown, wide open, that would have put the game away. Instead, the Saints had to punt.
Yeah, those have been the things that have been plaguing this team all season long, whether it's Cadet, Coleman, or someone else. They've made mistakes at inopportune times, and that's why they're 7-9 and out of the playoffs.
Ricky, you got to be careful in the final game of the season, not too much emphasis on how players play. You get a false positive sometimes in a final game of the season. You see a guy like Cadet have a real good game, or Coleman, and I'm not trying to tone it down. They did a nice job. They're worth looking at moving forward, but you can't get too excited about the final game of the season.
Well, you had 16 games, so you got to look at all 16 games. You can't bring it down to that last game, because I really didn't mean nothing. It had no meaning to it at all. I mean, even with the coach or anything, I see Coach Payton, the way he carried on after the game, but the game really didn't mean anything. I mean, you're out the playoff, and for me, having a Super Bowl ring, that's the only thing that count. So whenever you don't make the playoff, all the rest of the stuff don't mean nothing to
me. Here's what it meant by losing, rather by winning those last two games. They went from having as high as the 6th or 7th draft pick to having a 12th pick in the first round. Well, this was all about miscues this game, and who made the fewest? The New Orleans Saints made the fewest here. And here are the fourth quarter mistakes. Devontae Freeman, of course, the critical fumble. Now give John Jenkins credit. He forced it and he recovered it, and he's an improved football player. Travaris Cadet, of course, as I alluded to. And then you had Levitre. Adam Levitre with the unbelievably stupid play way after the whistle, running from 10 yards down the field to take the Falcons out of field goal range with a personal foul, and then, of course, the interception by Sanford. But, Ricky, if any play summarizes a team that's not a winner more than any other, it's the Levitre play. You can't do that.
No, I mean, that was stupid, Ken. For him to go get a penalty like that and cost his team, I don't know what he was thinking about. Because the play was dead. Everybody can see the play was dead. But, you know, Ken, I take my hat off to some of the Saints players. I mean, I look at some of the guys never stopped hustling. Some of them played their heart out. And that show you that, you know, like they always say, coaches going to look at who's still playing ball even though they're out of it. You know, the Saints had a couple of guys that really were still fighting.
Well, you look at this defense, Brian, and you're trying to think about who you're going to build with in the future. Who are the keepers? Let's look at that right now. I mentioned John Jenkins. I think he's earned a spot on a permanent basis. He showed improvement. Cam Jordan, obviously, up front. Those two start there. Linebacker, Ellerbe, can he stay healthy? I don't know. Stephon Anthony, definitely. Haole Kikaha faded a little bit in the second half, but he's a keeper. And then in the secondary, you got Keenan Lewis, certainly, coming back. You've got a guy that played very well in Delvin Bro. That's a keeper. So that's a pretty decent nucleus to start with.
Yeah, and, you know, you're absolutely right, Ken. Let me go back to your statement earlier. It's about you can't take this as a false positive, and that a lot of teams do this. Yeah, they finish with a little flurry down the stretch to finish 7-9. But the bottom line is they're 7-9. There's a reason why they got to 7-9. They do have some pieces on defense. We're going to talk about this ad nauseum as we go forward here, but they've got to get a decent, you know, they've got to get some help from a pass rush on the other side for Cam Jordan. And if they do that, that's going to help. It's going to help the rest of the defense.
What about this defense? Anybody else you like?
Well, you know, Ken, you know, first of all, start with the coordinator. I mean, you know, you want to see what kind of job he did when they got rid of Rex. Have he been the answer? You know what I mean? That's the first thing you're going to have to. You know what I mean? Do Peyton keep him if he's still around as the defensive coordinator? So those are the questions you have to ask, you know what I mean? I don't think the defense played well under him or Rex because they didn't have the talent. So those are the kind of things you got to worry about. Do they keep the coordinator?
No matter what happens on offense, I think we all agree, not only is Drew Brees back, but he should be back. The guy's still a great player. He led the NFL in passing this year. At his age, he put up unbelievable numbers. 11 interceptions, the fewest he's had in New Orleans, tied for the fewest, 32 touchdowns, 68% completions. You still build around this guy. He's still that good, Brian.
Kenny, I absolutely agree with you, but what's happened over the last 4 or 5 years since the Super Bowl season is that Drew has played at an elite level, continues to play at an elite level. They just haven't had that complementary defense to get them over the hump, and that is what, again, that they've got to concentrate on rebuilding, retooling during the offseason. They've got an offense. It's just not good enough to get to the big dance anymore.
But Brian, I tell you what, though, he played better down the stretch than he did early in the year.
Yeah,
he struggled.
Right.
During
but you would expect that with young players that he's playing with, too.
But Ken, you know what I mean? But his arm and different things, he didn't look as sharp during the year like he looked at the last 4 or 5 games.
He made every throw.
Right. Yeah.
Second half of the season, he made every throw you could possibly make and made great decisions, and he played hurt.
And they did a good job of protection over those games we're talking about. And look, we haven't even mentioned this, but they've got a patchwork offensive line yesterday as well. So
he makes the players around him better.
Yeah. And just like you say, too, I mean, he's $30 million on the cap.
Yeah.
So now you got to deal with that, too. You can't afford to have a $30 million quarterback.
You extend him.
I mean, but you got to take him down. I mean, it just
that's it. You extend him, that does take him down.
But do he want to? Would he accept that?
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? That's the thing.
And look, it's gonna have to take for him to want to do it, because if they don't get some money to work under the cap, you can't address the things that we've very well talked about.
And I think he'll do it. I really do.
Yeah.
But you extend him. All right. As a result of their finish, the Saints get third in their division. Thus, we know their schedule for 2016. Here it is. At home, the division games with Atlanta, Carolina, and Tampa Bay. St. Louis and their good defense, and Todd Gurley coming to town. Seattle, hello, Jimmy Graham's coming back home. Denver, is Peyton Manning coming here? Oakland Raiders, improved team, Jack Del Rio coming back. And Detroit, who whipped the Saints here this year, away. The division games, Atlanta, Carolina, Tampa Bay. Going to Arizona again, ouch. Going to San Francisco, will they be facing Sean Payton? Who knows? Kansas City, that's tough. They just won 10 in a row. San Diego, where are they going to be playing? And the New York Giants, and who's coaching that team? So it's kind of fun to speculate on all of this, and it's hard to comment on a schedule this early, Brian.
I know, because you know what? We looked at the schedule that they just completed, and we go, well, that's a winnable schedule right there. Well, they struggle, so you're right.
Well, this schedule
I'll tell you what,
tough.
The one thing I did notice, though, you look at all that schedule, you see those teams?
That schedule, that looked tough.
That looks a lot tougher.
That looked a lot tougher.
I was going to say the same thing.
Man, plus, there were about four teams I saw Sean Payton being rumored to be at.
So, yeah, I'm telling you, that schedule, that don't look too pleasing.
I was thinking the exact same thing.
Man.
We're on the same page about that. Much tougher looking, at least at first glance, than was last year. When we return in just a moment, we'll take a trip around the NFL, get you ready for the playoffs. But first, we want to remind you about Toyota of New Orleans. What a great place. Toyota of New Orleans is the place you need to go. Sports Noah TV is presented by Toyota of New Orleans, 11801 East I-10 Service Road in New Orleans East, home of Toyota's President Award recipient and the number one Toyota dealership in New Orleans in sales and customer satisfaction. Come to Toyota of New Orleans to get your dream car. You won't want to miss it. Toyota of New Orleans, I-10 Service Road at Bullard. Back to talk NFL in a moment.